Alright, can everybody hear me loud and clear? Can you hear me loud and clear? Everybody, it's about to go down. Let's do this. But I will still give pointers based on not having the upgrades and how you want to approach everything as you play through, right? So there are a few things we want to make sure we know how to do. The first thing I'll say is you have to try to learn the enemy patterns. That's necessary. Without knowing that, you're going to get smacked up every time. Like this room we're going into here, more than likely it's going to be like the little dog thingies in this area, like these guys right here. So if you stay too close to them, they will attack. So you always want to be moving. Like, see how he just jumped out after me here? So moving, cannot stress it, is the key here in this game. If you do not move, the enemies will smack you every time. So you want to keep moving. And you have to remember to use that dash. Like, your dash gives you invincibility, essentially. And you want to get as close to the dead bodies as you can, as quickly as you can, to get those obelisks. Your money. You need that. Let's see what we got for this matter. So, these I recommend not picking up if you're missing life. Don't pick them up. Only pick them up when your health is full, so that way you can increase your suit integrity, right? Two keys right off the roof. That's good. There we go. Let's pick that up. Maybe one more over here, so there we go. Now there's a pool already. Let's see what we got here. Awesome. So this is millennium. Now I have ether, so now that's too expensive. 5 ether is too expensive. You gotta be picky with your ether. Let me see. Do I have a place to kind of hide from it? Yeah, can I have it? So let's see. So I'm going to try to avenge this dead body. I always do, because they always drop good stuff. But the problem is, if they're infected, they come out and they smack you immediately. So you want to stand kind of like this and kind of prepare to run away. So let's see what happens here. So it's fine. So we're going to avenge this. And I'm going to go get ready now for war. So that bad boy has a blazer, so you want to stay away from that as much as possible. As you can see, I already got smacked. My adrenaline is now reset. Yeah, he is. These things are relentless. The lasers are the worst thing ever. Come down here, buddy. Oh, that's bad. Yeah, I'm dead. I'm definitely dead. I'm dead. So that was a bad risk. Alright, let's start it over. So here we go. You see, it was about how many times I would die. We like that? Yes, definitely. Alright, let's do it. Oh, wait a minute now. They're being nice to me today. So pay attention for that as well. At the end of a death, sometimes they actually put stuff in cool positions to help you out. These guys kind of suck because they come up all around you, front and behind. And you only really need to focus on the ones that are aiming like a laser thing at you. Let's see what we got here. Drop double resistance to suffer damage when picking up items. No, that's crazy. I'm going to pick this one up. Let's see, what does it say? It feels one slot. Yeah, this one feels like regardless. So, pick that one up. Come on, that's not what I wanted to do. Dirty to put him out of battle himself. Hold on. Blue doors on the map, by the way. Blue triangle doors are little upgrade doors. We don't have a key. We had two keys last round. And yes, you lose everything whenever you die. Fun stuff. Alright, here we go. That bad boy did hit me. Great stuff. Only need to worry about these guys when they turn kind of red. That's when they're about to attack. So this room, you want to go into when you're a little bit more comfortable. So these rooms with the stars are like upgrade rooms. There's a ton of stuff in them, including a ton of enemies. So. Let's see here. There's a chest up here. Should we tempt fate again is the question. Yes, we will. Because we live a risky life. In this game. On an alien planet might as well act like... And she's there. Is it malignant? Oh, I'm about to get myself in some trouble here. Let's see what we got this time. You again. Oh, he has the fun lasers this time. Whoa, that almost hit me. I missed the hole. I wanted to go down and no, I wanted to fall down there. Hold that, sucker! So let's see what upgrade they upgraded us to here. We'll take that. We'll take the carbine. We absolutely will. So, we got a little touched up. That's okay. We lost our adrenaline, but that's fine. What's down there? There's something. It says that there's something down in this hole. What is this? Yes, please. Let's go into the upgrade room. I'm feeling a bit adventurous. Where is it at? Where is it at? It's down in the hole. So let's go. Wow, something hit me already. They are not playing. They are not playing. Jesse had fought me, we don't want to live. Nope. What is this? Alright, next phase, here we go. Oh, bane of my existence. Nobody likes this. Oh wait, and they got the tree dude with them? Oh my god. Like 50 of these things, what in the heck? Oh, so you bad, huh? Slows down time on even. Oh, that's a nice idea. Typical, bro. Typical. Typical Returnal stuff. Falling in holes for no reasons and stuff. You have to.
be a big one.
So, if you're playing for the first time, you're not going to see some of these guns. You're not going to see the Electropylon Driver. You won't see that. That is easily my favorite gun, so I'm going to pick it up. But if you're playing, if it's your first playthrough, you're not going to see this gun. Just letting you know. The way this gun works is it sticks a pylon in the ground and it does that. Enemies that walk within this get hurt continuously. If you stick it in the enemies, even more juicy stuff happens, okay? Let's see what's going on down here. So how many does he want? 5, E3, yeah, we can do that. Let's see what happens here. So this is another gun you won't see. It's a very, it's an aggressive gun. You need to be close to the enemies because it has 3 rounds, but the way it works is if you shoot them off, you gotta wait till they come back. So if you're close to the enemy, it's insane. If you miss, can't shoot. So this is my gun right here. If you just started a playthrough, you also can't do this. This you get in the second biome, I believe, the grappling hook. So you won't be able to use this or access that area or some areas without it. So you gotta wait till you get to biome number 2. So with my favorite gun in tow, only has 2 rounds, and that's literally all you need. This gun is so good. I could take this gun and go kill the last boss with it right now. Or we're gonna do what we said, we're gonna make it through all the biomes. I might even get a little excited and go kill the first boss just for fun. Now let's do this. Where we at here? I don't even know what hit me there. Oh wait, I see red shots. That means there's a... Yep, I didn't see you. That's what I didn't see. So as you can see, this gun is very effective in handling crowds. You set down some of those webs, and that is a wrap. Let's go ahead and oh wait, there's one enemy left? Is there still a thing? I can see a red marker on the map. Seriously? Dog, why are you out there by yourself, my guy? I apologize that you had to take that, but yeah, your friends kind of just left you out, didn't they, bud? Okay, so through this door, we would have been able to go to the Crimson Wastes, which we're going to go through in a second. We're not coming here yet. This is like, that's like your second biome. It's open for me because I already finished the level. Right, but like I said, we're doing them all today. Checking for a little upgrade room. Typically there's a little room we can go into for upgrade, but I guess we're not that lucky. Now, you might see me doing this weird jump. So this is a dash, right, a regular dash, but then a swing, jump all in one. That lets you like cover insane distances. So I just jump from all the way over there, that jump. So you can cancel a swing into a jump. Now when you dash and you swing and jump at the same time, you keep all the momentum. So it takes a little time to figure it out, but that's kind of like what it looks like. But when you figure it out, you realize how effective it is and how useful. So let's go in here. So this room is not one of my favorites because of how vertical it is. And there could be any number of some crazy enemies, like for example, this bad boy right here has a shield. Set the trap, walk into it, boom, hold that. Where the rest of the little friends at? So that means I need to make my way all the way to that bad boy because he has that shield before I can kill him. Hit him with the, you can only hit stuff with the shield, with your blade. Oh, hello, another one. So now I'll keep the one that I currently have. The game likes me tonight for some reason. I think it was because of that pathetic death I had at first. Try it. Oh, that looked like it hurt, bro. You're not gonna make it. So that's how this gun works, and that's why I like it.
little bit higher, you're going to win.
All right. So, although the game is randomly generated, one of the most important things is some of the rooms will always have the same layout. So you just have to remember them. They hide stuff all over these rooms. So always make sure to look around and learn the layouts of the rooms. It's a massive advantage. It can be a massive, massive advantage. This gun is not doing ridiculous amounts of damage. Look at that. Got all these bullets right there. Why did my obelisk just go into the orbit? Maybe someone could tell me. Oh, look at that. There's one up right there. Zoom. So without the grappling hook, of course, you might not be able to access. I don't think you can access this platform. Yeah, you can't. It's too high. You can't access it without the grappling hook, FYI. I always get the health refills, especially the large ones, irreplaceable when you get into as much trouble as I get into. So the astronaut will let you come back if you die. We're not doing that. Getting it reduces all fire cooldown and a low interior. So we're not, I don't think I need any of those. I'm not gonna die. I just know I won't. I died earlier, that was one death, that was enough. I don't need any more deaths, I'm good. Let's keep pressing on. And here come the oh. Why would they do that? Well, that was a lot of enemies. There might be one more left. Almost got hit. I didn't realize he shot his stuff off. He went through the paws and shooting his stuff off. It went through the grass there. Alright, so that was a quick little... So whenever you see those red balls in a room, those red glowing balls where they're about to like bring in a crazy enemy, the doors will lock. You cannot go back out. You have to defeat it for the doors to be reopened. So I'm going to use this translocation sphere to see where it takes me, see if it gives me anything. Okay, well, nice. Weapon room. Let's see what we get here. Dreadbound. Not doing that. So the Hollow Seeker is also a pretty good weapon, and the Tendril Pod thing is very good. Shoots out a pod, sticks to the enemies, and continuously damages them. So if I get that on my gun that I'm using right now, typically I'll do that, because that is highly effective. Also, the good news is, whenever you kill one of those enemies, those malformed enemies, they always drop a weapon. It's all usually very strong. So that's another thing to point out with that. So let's see what upgrades are in this room for us. So typically, all of the upgrades in Biome 1, you could always get to like these little health bits. You don't necessarily need the grappling or anything else to get to them. Where is the button to open this door? There it is, right there. So what's in this chest? Let's find out. Now, this is also a very good weapon. It's damage over... Any weapon that does damage over time in this game, you want. That's my humble opinion. I ain't no pro, but I would definitely recommend it. So, there is also another suit signal detected. I mean, somebody got smacked up. So we gotta see where the body is first. Usually the body's not far. I can't see it. I like to shoot the gun next to where the body is, this gun that I use. And this is a good idea too, if you have this gun, to do it. Because if the body is malignant and it attacks you, or whatever it is sometimes, if it spawns right there, it takes damage immediately. Oh, there it is right there. Okay, and we're avenging it. Okay, I got myself in some trouble. This guy's aim. Dead. And that's why I say this gun is effective. And whoever that dead person was, you're welcome. And it drops it. Oh yeah. And look at this. An upgraded version of my gun. Can't be mad at that. Also has more rounds. Let me see, does it still do it? Still does a decent enough web. So look at that. So using this gun is a little bit more strategic than a regular gun. But very effective once you figure it out. This improves chances of finding salvage from hostiles. That is always a good find. I think there's something missing here. Oh, it's right in here. Yeah, we can do that. A key liquidifier. Do I want to do that? So converts carried keys into maximum integrity. Oh, let's do it. But doesn't actually give you the integrity, right? Good job. I feel bad killing these dudes sometimes because they're like harmless. But they are obelisks. They give you a ton of obelisks and sometimes some consumables. And they disappear after some time. So now this room, if you're playing for the first time, obviously you can't get in the water. You don't have the underwater. I obviously do, so we're gonna get the water. These little guys are usually very lucrative. They usually give you something, which will help you upgrade your little health there. So not today for us. Ether is the only thing you keep in this game when you die, so go out of your way to keep that ether no matter what. You go out of your way to keep it. Ah, yes, I just remembered I was missing health pistons. Cheater, how are you going to give me health and not give me health? You know what I'm saying? Oh, the Sub-Zero Pulse, I like this thing. So you could use that to literally freeze enemies in place for a few seconds. You won't have that when you start off. This will be found on a data cube after completing the game and doing a couple playthroughs. It becomes a discoverable data cube, and you don't want to miss that bad boy. If you pick up a data cube that has this stuff on it, you definitely want to go ahead and turn that data cube in. In other words, don't die. So these rooms, I hate as well, because guess what? That thing, that pillar I just destroyed, oh, you dead, Bob, I hate you. There's two of these punks in here, bro. Where's the other one? Oh, now you come to play too. Okay, come on in. There he is. Oh, you suck, guy, you be smart. You try to just show up sometimes when you're not looking. I think everything's dead. Nope, something's still alive. What's still alive? Okay, everything's dead. Okay, cool, cool. Movement, guys, movement. Don't ever stop and try to figure out where they're at. Just keep moving, and yeah, you might not die. I say a might. That's a huge might, because this game is this game. It will kill you when you least expect. Like, what's over here? What is this for? This is definitely a hit. This is definitely a hit. Yep, it actually did hit me. It did. Repairs off and yeah, we'll do that. What happens here is you heal more when you use a healing item, you get more health, only 25% more health. So that's, I'll always say you have to do that as an upgrade. But there are some key upgrades you definitely want. For me, the biggest one is the bonus damage based on your adrenaline level. Never miss out on that. So let's do the upgrade room, then we'll do the red room. I don't have no keys, I just use my keys, so I can't go anywhere. So we're gonna go fight the first. No, we're not gonna go do that yet. I left some rooms unattended, I believe. Let's take a look at the map. So in here, I believe that blue door that I didn't go into would have taken us somewhere else. I think we hit every door on this map except for this one. Why not? I forget. Oh, I couldn't break it. I need to break it with the upgraded blade. That's what it is. So we're streaming 33 minutes. We gotta go. So are we gonna go fight the boss or not? So let's see. Let's make up our mind here. Yes. Forget it. Let's go. He's really easy though. For those people who have not fought him yet, I'll do like a quick walkthrough while I'm fighting. Are you kidding me, bro? Oh, come on. I didn't see that one. I didn't see him, bro. Now my junk keeps it. Terribly. What's in this? How much do you want for this? 3. I could do that. Nah. I'm picking that up. Come on, let's go. So, that last room that we were in, typically if you're doing your first playthrough, you get a key for that door and then you come fight the boss. My recommendation is, typically on your first playthrough, if you get that key and you come fight the boss, you're going to get smacked up. What you want to do is get that key, go back to the room where you could actually purchase like the healing stuff, and then come to this room. So Harry is the first boss. I know he's giving some people grief. His name is Frike, Pike, however you want to say it. I don't know. But we're going to smack him up for you real quick. Look how elegant he is. Look at him. I got 3 arms, but I'm upgraded. And what you are is dead, sir. What you are is dead. Nap, bro. Phase 3 time, baby. Let's go. You mad? Mad. Hold that. That's funny how his attacks still come out. And that'll be a team. That'll be first boss there. Oh yeah, deal more damage. Let's go. Azila. Damage to a personal item. Increases invulnerability time after getting hit. Hopefully we don't have to use it that much. Now we're gonna teleport to... let's go. No, I don't have slot on keys. So we're gonna teleport. I think it's here, right? No, I think it's here. Yeah, we need to go here so we can go through that door. Pretty sure. To the desert, baby. Now, of course, when you get it, you do not get half this, so you can't get up and access this stuff, so I'm going to go ahead and get it. It is what you want to remember. You will get it in this level, though. So you will get the grapple hook in this level after beating the boss here. I'm not going to pick that up, there's too much ether. What's this? Dropped obelisk as some damage to the keys, that's a no. So these things you can do an entire playthrough without using these. Some of them make sense, like this here increases the chance of finding manipulated items. I don't care. I believe if you find a manipulated item you need, you use your ether to get it unless you're doing a run just to save ether for the next one. So I'm going to get this bad boy here because I don't pick up many malignant things anyway. I just need my obelisks to come to me. My obelisks are expensive. They're not expensive. They're important because you're going to be buying a lot of items to heal yourself. That's always my recommendation. So. This level you always want to back up and see, because I tell you what, there are some enemies, the flying enemies in this level will sneak up on you from behind. They're quiet and they're deadly. I'll say in this game it's movement. Watch my gun work. Oh my god, it's so beautiful. Absolutely beautiful stuff. Now let's see what we got in this little first section here. I know we have you. We're gonna avenge you. Don't worry about it. Let's see what we got. Nah, I'm good. Let's see if you could find the dead body first of all, so we can plant it, if you know what I mean. Where did this person die? Come on, bro. Well, there we go, right here. Okay. not militant, so we're Avenging. Oh, them dudes are savage, boy. Oh, I hate this dude. This guy right here. Watch this. Oh, if you want to stay up there, I'm cool with that, but I'm good. You know what I'm saying? Oh, this game is liking me today. Just stayed up there. That's nice. Boom, baby. Profit. Yeah. This is all malfunctions. You don't ever get malfunctions, really. But I know he dropped a gun as well. Let's go to the gun and drop. Where's the gun? What is this? Oh, game, what did you do? Yo. Well, whatever. We missed the gun. This is a trap. There's no way they just give me a free chest. I'm surprised some random stuff didn't just jump out the window. There's another room under here, which I need a key. How do I even get to? Oh, it's on the back here. We don't have no key, so. This is an upgrade room. You see these little lights. What up, bro? Nah, I ain't playing that new world. You can forget it. Y'all over there grinding, bro. I don't like the peer pressure, bro. The peer pressure, though. Oh, yeah, give me that. 2 million files. You cannot beat that. All right, let's go. All intents and purposes, let's go ahead and start making our way out of there. So we're gonna go to the left over here. That's where they kind of want to go. Missing my jumps. Look, this is quiet in the air over here. What you doing over there, partner? Look, this one even managed to get some shots off. I just didn't even see. It's time to die, Ralstaff. Gotta watch these enemies, bro. We're not too competitive. Alright, let's see what we got in this little big area here. What is this? It's a cube. And is that a health I see somewhere there? Oh yeah, exactly. I'm picking that up. Hexing that up. And these chests right here, you gotta be aware of. They will spawn enemies. So you set traps, you know what I'm saying? For example. That's why you set them traps. Another parasite. Reduces malfunction probability. Said, well, nope, I need to pick up a ton of items. That ain't happening. Let's go see over here now. You require a key as well. Oh, I don't think I need to do that. Let's see, where do we need to go from here? So we need to go left. open space where we don't have paper. Wow, this thing almost got me. That and get some more. There we go. Give me that health bar, baby. I swear I heard some enemies. Did I hear enemies spawn or was it just me? This is a very good weapon you will get in the last biome, but it is not effective here. The last biome is underwater, by the way, in case you didn't know. The underwater biome, the explosions are way more effective there. Alright, let's see if they try to surprise me with going over here too. Get it. Wanna get busy in that? Haha. Usually there's a little room over here you can come into. I call it a free upgrade. I'm not opening that chest, bro. I call it a free upgrade because this is usually what's in this room. You can come get, just open up some chests, and there might be a glyph or something in there for you to scan if you're on your first playthrough. So this bad boy costs 3. I thought we got 17. Let's see what's in it. Yes, sir. We have 4 healing vials. Oh, we on a roll. Oh, no. Square. Recycles a nearby weapon. Nah, I don't need that. Get up, man. Get up. People here kneeling and stuff. So the story of this game is what, to me, is the craziest thing. I'm not going to speak on it because if you are going to be playing for the first time, you need to discover that for yourself. But the story of this game is really incredible. This room you want to come back to before you exit the level because there is a glyph to scan in there for sure. Now, because I've already made it to the top, you can go through this right now and make it all the way to the top and go find the boss. But like I said, we're doing a playthrough, so we're going here. So if it's your first playthrough, when you get here, this is where you discover the weapon called the Hollow Seeker. Oh, it's about to shoot me. Let's go back to the ether. Sorry, distracted there. So if you play the game for the first time, when you get in here, what you would find here is the Hollow Seeker, the gun. This is where you actually discover it. What do you say, Parasite? What do you got? Fabrication is less, great increases no melee cooldown. You never want to mess with. You always want that to be either less or as normal. Your melee and your dash are irreplaceable in this game. I cannot stress that enough. We do some turret right there. Okay, let's see, what do we have in this room? The upgrade room is to the left, so we go left. I'm taking you all into all the upgrade rooms. Not skipping one. So this one might have been a bad idea. I've had a corner just like an issue. I got hit. I So the turret actually hit me, FYI. So that's why I no longer have a shield all over me. So this is always a good upgrade. The Blade Enhancer allows you to break golden shields. Not just red ones, but also golden ones. And what is this here? A Repair Enhancer. Remember that? What is this? A projectile board. Always keep that notification sphere. I don't need it. I'll keep the notification sphere instead. Now, if you see down there, there's also a body we could avenge. So would I do it? Absolutely. I never turn those down. All I need to find is now, this may be death. So when you just start, you can't, of course, like I said earlier, you can't get in the water, so I'm going to get it. Get these upgrades here. It's always good stuff in the water. So we need to figure out an exit route when we start fighting this thing, so we know where we can run to and where we can hide. Let's see if there's so I could use that to get to the higher level. Bro, wait, are you kidding me? Is that I kill an enemy and the health stayed up there? That is fabulous. This game is not without fault, let me tell you. Okay, so here we go. Where's the dead body? Right here. This person runs around and acts like they're superhuman and stuff. I'm gonna set up some traps in case this thing is gonna just put it. It is. Dead. I avenged you. Be happy. So one of my biggest issues playing this game is I can't, I don't know why, I just have to get into these rooms. I see a door and I go in. It's just what I do. Not always the best of ideas, let me tell you. So this gooey stuff on the bottom here, you will also gain protection from this, and I will show you where you get that a little bit later on in the game. But you can get an upgrade to protect you from the damages or the stuff that this causes. So what do we have here? Is this a damage augment? Yes, we'll do that. We're going to raise our damage by 10%, which is always fabulous. And we've used all our augments right now. So typically, I think there is usually a glyph in this room for you to scan. If you want to do like that completion thing, I was thinking really about that, completing the whole game. So we're not picking that up. So here we have a chest. So we need to set up some traps in case something is spawned. They didn't. They gave me up. But it's a good job, game. So typically, when you just start playing, this would hurt you. See that again? This would smack you, but we get that protection. So let's get out of here. Let's go smack us a boss. So I need to go up one level. Here's the thing. My health up there. That, man, I wanted my health. That's crazy. Hey, buddy. What's up, buddy? Go get this work. Oh, boy. One of the corrupted ancient dudes. These dudes are there. Always have to pay attention. Like right there, he was about to teleport in and kill me. So you watch for that red, like, makes a red tether to you, and when it glows red, then you want to dash. If you dash before that, it's too soon. He will definitely smack you up. got too close there, block it. Might not be able to fully access this upgrade room if you don't have the you won't be able to fully access it. Because I believe there's also a glyph up here you scan as well. But what you'll be able to do is come down here and see what it goes behind door number two. In here is going to be one of those little historical rooms. I'm not going to go into room or anything, but you can come learn more about the history of the game, the process that we took, and how she got there, and whatever. So let's get out of there. We don't need to be there. This is actually a pretty good gun. For the boss we're about to fight, this gun might actually be better than the one I have, but just to move things moving and not have to change strategies and the way that I fight, I'll keep the gun that I got. Oh, now what did I miss? Seems like there was something that I missed. Don't suggest me. How do you get that purple stuff up there? What's that purple thing? I know, I got a problem. Working on it, working on myself. There it is. Ether, see that? Bro, let me tell you. Alright, this is usually when you get halfway in a level, you find yourself in this room here where you could actually purchase some more stuff. So nullification sphere, we're gonna replace that with a large healing vial. Let's see, we only have 70 execution by medic. Oh man, that's a good one. Yeah, this is a good one. Energy blast for melee kills. Alright, so let's go. Let's move on. This is where this level tries to get serious. We're ready to kill more bodies. And yeah, don't be afraid to back out of a room because you want to save yourself. It is necessary. Yeah, thank you. That's beautiful. Only two rounds, but I don't care. It does the whip. The whipping does boom back. Ah, that's beautiful. Bro, they really put this dude right here. That's nuts. And my gun is crazier than he was, so hold that, player. Yeah, how about that? That's nuts they put it in right here. I'd rather they put all the crazy lasers like they usually do. On your first playthrough, he will not be there. Let me go ahead and say that. I love this. You did. All of y'all did. Yeah, I can't really go to the house. And I'm about to play your games, bro. See, that's how you get smacked up. Stuff hidden behind walls, you don't know where they're at. That's different. Trying to get hit when I'm not looking. Mm-hmm. feel better now. Killed it. Now we need to get up there. Ooh, chest. Free chest. I'm good. Alright, now let's go back out here. And now we can get up there. This gap is not meant to be jumped because, oh, I didn't do it right. I didn't get close enough. But we could make that jump by using our super jump thingy. So this room always finds a way to smack me up. So that's why we go to it every time. Okay, I heard them. Where are they at? Come to me. Come get it. Come get this weapon, baby. It's all yours. When he dies. Oh, almost got me. Almost got me. Go away, go away, go away, go away. Smack. Smack, 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 smack. Get them all? What's this? Nah, I'm good. Nah, I'm good. I gotta do the upgrade rooms, man. I'm sorry. I got a problem. I know. I got a problem. Nope, don't want that. Very good gun, but I just don't want it. It fires a single shot, which obliterates stuff. I'm just gonna say that. This is the worst thing in the game. Don't ever do this. It always hurts you and gives you a dumb. Gives you a dumb item. You can avoid this altogether. And still have a great playthrough. Oh, who's in there? I didn't check. I think I already have one of that. I got two of them. Usually there's some free stuff in here. So we have a key liquidifier and a residual square. So I have one key. Do I need a key? Do I need... Nah, we need more health because we're greedy. So we're going to do that. Oh, he's it. I'm going to do it. So yeah, when the key liquidifier hit up, there goes our health getting bigger, and we're back.
Yep,
let's do it. Hey, don't be mad at me, bro. Okay, now this, you always want to do, but this one, there's a caveat to this, I would say. So... this always increases your health and heals you, but there's a strong possibility that enemies spawn after using it. So always do what I just did right there. So we got enough health not to fight off anything. We just try not to get hit right now, that's it. So these rooms, you gotta watch out. Like right here, see, for example, there's a ton of these bad guys for sure, right? Because there's gonna be, and in these rooms, they're way more aggressive than normal. Oh my god. Yep, I got hit right there.
accurate.
Well, there seems to be a ton of health in here, so I should be able to get myself back into a fairly decent condition. That kind of sucked. To really increase my integrity rather than just eating. Nope, I've seen these tricks before. This one gives you a random item. You never know, maybe it's a not this time, it's not good this time, it's a consumable. Nope, I don't need that. So I just wasted like 75 off this. Great. Usually, well, not usually, there's gonna be two enemies in here, you need to smack them up real quick. What did he do? That's a lot of junk, partner, on my screen. Oh, wow. What happened? What is it? It's just you. Oh, brought friends. Ooh. Oh, wow. What the heck? Where did he come from? Bro, this game, bro. This is the last run up to the actual boss fight. Forgot to hit the dash button, bruh. It was that simple. Wow. I'm so mad, bro. Adrenaline level 1. So, by the way, when we beat the boss and we get the grappling, we get to come back over here and then go through that portal that just opened up to go to the third level. So, here we are about to fight the boss. And before every boss, by the way, they do give you a gun. Usually it's the handgun. It's pretty decent, but no, I don't care. So here we go. Thank you. got smacked up way more than I should have, but anyway. He's dead. So at this point you would have gotten the grappling hook, which would let you do this. And then to me at this point, from that point on in the game, it's a wrap. I think I have one parasite on. Let's get it off. So this little machine removes your parasites and spits out obelisks. So whoa, almost fell down the hole again. Pause. So this is probably the most frustrating biome in the entire game, is biome 3, and I think this is where we're going to probably call it a night for tonight once we get done with this biome, because a lot of people get smacked up there. And I'll say the biggest thing with this biome is learning the drones. The drones are what usually smacks us, and I say us because I am not immune. The drones will smack us up. Learning their actual behavior is key. The rockets, you always want to go towards the rockets. Never go away from the rockets. So when you're dashing, dash towards the rockets at all times. It's my best advice. These guys will just charge you until they get right up on you, and they will more than they detonate themselves, is what they do. So enemy patterns are the biggest thing. So we should come in once you're like, hey, nope, not doing that, too much risk. Risk management. If you want to learn risk management, this is the way to do it. Play this game, you will learn risk management. So there is a platform down here we want to get to. I don't think there's any enemies. We get a free little health piece right here. Boom, now I own this longer. There will be enemies on this bridge. Never fight them here. Always run away. Go over here and do this. Never fight them because you have nowhere to hide, bro. So always do this. Get them to come to you at all times. That's how you survive in this biome. You get enemies to come to you, do not go to them. So this fool is still left by the sea. That's what I'm talking about right here. Now typically this room has the thing you can lay in to increase your integrity. And I always recommend coming over and doing that, because usually in this biome, in this room, there's always two health pickups. One or both of them might be malignant, but it's better, I swear, it's somewhere enemy spawn. Don't see anything on the map, but you gotta be cautious. But it's always better to use ether on malignant stuff rather than risking getting a malignancy. I see a ton of help, so I'm gonna hang out here and fight enemies that might get smacked up. But it's better. Are there any? Some of the enemies here don't even attack you. You do not attack. This is the joke I'm gonna get rid of here at this level. Probably that was better. Okay, so it says increases proficiency rate by 20% one additional kill. Nah, we're not proficiency in a big deal, because your proficiency will always be automatically leveled. Every time you go to a new level, you will pick up a little thing that will greatly suffer damage from long falls. I'm doing it. We just gotta make sure we don't take long fall damage. That's all. Calibrator right here. So, where's the dead body? Let's scan it, then we're gonna lace the dead body with projectiles as much as we can and get out of dodge before it kills us. Immediately hit me. My shield's gone. That's what I'm talking about. That's right. Got hit again. Adrenaline is not reset. Fantastic. Golly, bro. I hate these dudes, bro. And I can't help myself. Like, I gotta hit him. I gotta hit him every time. I just got to. This guy does not miss. If you come across this guy, you gotta kill him quick. He does not miss. Let's see what they drop from me. What is this? Cool down. Bro, I did not see these lasers at all. Oh my god, I could have smacked myself up, didn't even realize. There's anything up here with value? Alright, let's cleanse it. Let's see if we can upgrade our gun. Give me my gun. Right, nope, don't want it. Very good gun. Don't want it still. I'm picky, man. Replaced with that. Easy choice. Oh, that is that. I need 400 opulence, bro. Now, these right here, these orbs. In your first playthrough, you will not see them. This is an upgrade you only gain after making it to the sixth biome, which is the underwater biome. This is actually necessary to finish the game. Literally, you can't finish the game if you don't get this upgrade, and the game actually needs you to get it. There's no way around it. So you could ignore that. As you can see, there's nothing really there for me right now. Okay, hold on. And I've been very lucky. I haven't seen any drones on this playthrough in this part of this game, which is cool. Which made me one of two things. That means the drone is real. Oh, hello. Came right up to me like, you want something? Okay, what's showing up here? I did get hit. moving. I don't care if it's one enemy, I'll keep moving because I don't know where the next, where the rest of them are gonna pop up from. Because I could see behind this wall there were two enemies back there. So what's up with that? It is. No need to panic. Oh, so that's an upgrade. I'm going in there, bro. I can take him. I can take him with this gun, man. I can take him. I know I can. Drones. They did not give me drones. I am lucky. I am the luckiest one. Here come the drums. Here they are. Biscuit for the biscuit. What gun is this? Nope, I can't do that. Right, let's get up here and heal up, apparently. Getting hit causes your suit to emit an explosion. We gotta keep it. Awesome. Alright, let's get out of here. Wrong way. So just so y'all know, that was entirely unnecessary. I did it just because I couldn't help myself. I got a problem, I know. And thank you. So shield breaker on this one. So this is perfect for the boss. The shield breaker is great, and it doesn't do the web. So for the boss, that's good. I could actually pinpoint my shots. I don't know why I feel like there's stuff down here for me to hit. I feel like they're trying to make me look down here like there's something down here, bro. See, yes, there's a door down here. So if you're playing for 100%, there might be something down there you might need to go look at. So then you know that, right? So then it's good info. Nah, we don't need that. Let's go over here. I think that's where we need to be going, right? Yeah, apparently. We'll get there. We'll get there eventually. Let's go over here. I see an upgrade door. I can't help myself. We're going to go into it. That's what kind of trouble this is. So this you want to use if you think you're going to die. This will actually let you reset yourself in the stage. So it does cost 6 ether right now. So what happens is if you die, you respawn here like nothing happened. Like you're a fresh newborn baby. And also this is one of those rooms where it'll let you drop down And you could actually get like a treasure chest or something from here or some other locations at the bottom. We don't need to do that. We just have to figure out where we're going to get out of here. I need to keep going forward. Yes. Good argument. Oh, we actually dropped it. So when you're doing your first playthrough, this light will not be on. I've already turned that on. I'll show you where it comes on in a second. Whoa, that was close. Didn't follow my golden rule and didn't keep moving. Almost got hit. Oh, I like this. What y'all got? Down here. Oh my god, I thought I was performing. Man, this window goes out of something. Oh, whoa, they're so angry up there. Why are they so mad? Ugh. So one of the perks of this gun is that it will drop, it'll make enemies drop self-heal, which you cannot complain about at all. So this will replace the portal projector. I love this. Okay, finisher, blade armor, and self-heal extractor. We're picking this up, baby. Keep giving me my gun. Keep giving me my gun. Do this. I better stop it. Sure, great, give me that. I don't even do those things, no way. Cleanse. It seems like it was under the water. Oh, wow. Whoa, where did he come from? Okay, I might have overreacted, but y'all can tell the reflex is on point, right? You know what I'm saying? Look at that. I've been missing this glyph the whole time. This is why. Trophy. Got him. Alright, let's open it up, see what we got. Very good gun, but I'm a pass on that. I'm a solid pass on that. Alright, let's see. Where do we gotta go next? So, door is straight in, and if I'm not mistaken, I see a ton of enemies in this room already. Hello. And the fool at the end of the hall got a laser. That's what we're doing? I'm embarrassed. Bro, why is this room so stressful, bro? Makes sense. Crap, bro. me out of there, bro. That sucked. I didn't like that room. That room was annoying. I got all my health back, which is cool. But I was still annoyed. Ah, cool. Oh no. No way, man. What is going on in that room? Why are there so many enemies in there? That's nuts. That's crazy. I've never seen this room behave this way. There's like 20 of these bad boys in there. That's nuts. I've never been in this room before. The destruction is torn through us. So I would basically only came to this room for us to get smacked up and get one health block. Like, here you go, here's some health, since we know you're gonna get smacked up in this room. Like 20 of them robots in here. That's nuts. So I don't like this. Like I said, I don't like this. Look at that. Are you kidding me, bro? All out of nowhere. Like, the game is like, nah, that's too much help. Yeah. Oh, he's here. Oh my god. You're gonna have to come down to fight me, partner. I ain't coming up. Oh no. You come down here, you alright. Come on. He dead. I'm pretty sure he's dead. See how they try to smack you up in this game, bro? That was a little nerve-wracking right there. I did not expect a big boy to be like out here this quickly, this angry. So typically you would come in here and you would put the thing in there and you would get your little story bit and the light would come on and then you would get to go across. And it would take you all the way back right there to the bridge. Now that you hear the bridge over there would open up. As you can see, it's already open because I already have this big problem. Man, this thing took a bit of damage. Oh. So this bridge finally opens up. So after you go, like, it takes you back here, you go to the bridge. But you were at this bridge because of this. Might be two more, but you will hear them. You have to listen. Yep, there we go. Yeah. Now, this water here, obviously, you can't get into. When you're done your playthrough, you want to make sure you come back here and get in this water. There's something very important down here that you're going to want. So, we're making our final ascent to one of the most hated bosses in all of recent gaming history. And here's what I'll say for this dude. Just, you got to learn his pattern, first of all. How he attacks and he has his little minions around him. You gotta keep your eye on him, Jokers. They're your biggest concern. His attacks are not that serious. But of course, I'll show you guys what I do and how I get around. And here's the other thing that makes people mad too. So believe it or not, when you're done here, when you're done with this third biome, as hard as it is, you actually lose everything again when you start the next biome. Sounds kind of crazy, but that's exactly what it is. You lose everything again when you stumble on this guy. My dash should be back. I've never got hit in this room, so I'm not too worried about it. Never got hit in this room. And dash. That's why you want to have that stronger blade later in the game. It does come in quite handy. What is this? I think now I'm not going to get the shield battle. I'm just going to get the projectile. I'm going to keep the projectile portal. I'm going to keep that. Matter of fact, here's what I'll do. I'm going to use it now. I'm going to pick this bad boy up again. So now I have a shield. If I lose it on the way to the boss, fine. But you don't really need to be at level 5 adrenaline for this boss. It's not very difficult at all, to be honest. It's not difficult once you learn his patterns. Like I was saying, is learning his patterns are the most important thing. Once you figure that out, this room we're about to go into, though, you have to be ready for. I'm just gonna let you know right now. This room is I messed up. This room is beyond savage. If you don't know what you're doing. Myself into a corner, but that was delivered. It's like a hot gate, you know what I'm saying? I did get touched up. I did, but again, it's fine. It's like a hot gate. So this room here is your final run to the boss. That's why it's a good room. And it'll get even more ridiculous further up. And I'll show you why. I recommend blowing past this room if you have the option to do that. Do not hang around. Do not play. Don't try to go past gold plates or $100. But just make your way out of the room as quickly as possible is my recommendation. Because you're going to see why. So I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. I'm going to just go past everything right here real quick. I'm going to go to the portal and I'm going to go up. Right? Because these dudes right there that are spawning can also do this, right? So the first time I made it through here with a decent amount of health, I was like, oh yeah, I'm going to smack up the boss. I'm ready. I got everything I need, right? So I'm like, let me come over here and get my adrenaline up. Do you see what just happened there? They will jump up here and come get you. So yeah, don't, unless you want to be like me and you want to live dangerously. I gotta do it right now. That level. You see what I'm talking about? This is me doing what I do, killing myself. This is why most of us don't finish these levels. This kind of stuff happen all the time. Now I did that just to see if I can get a better gun, to be honest with you, I'm not gonna lie. Sometimes they drop really good guns. Oh, what was that? Check down. So we could actually now, it's not as dangerous down at the bottom. We could go back down to the bottom now, but now we won't do that. I should actually go back to the room where I could purchase more integrity, but we're really not going to need it. This boss is not going to stand a chance. Nah, I'm good. So, I don't want to have any spoilers, so I'm not even going to let you see what he does, since he's one of the most important bosses there is. Kablowie. Down he's what you see what he does right there. You want to watch for that. And his friend comes and takes a turn too. So they're gonna aim it at where you're standing. So this is why I always say moving in this game is critical. So that's phase one of this boss. What you want to watch for is watch where this Joker moves to. Or these little minions move to. That's how you know. So where are they going? Where are they going? Over here. So I need to be over here. Now his little friends will do something a little different. You need to dash through this. And his buddy's gonna come have a go. Oh, I went too early there. And ladies and gentlemen, that's actually the second phase. Oh, he made it? Punk! Dead, yep. This is one of my favorite things about this boss fight. He doesn't like you getting close to him. And I don't want to no spoilers again. So Can I skip it? It's not letting me skip this portion. Unfortunately, I apologize. I don't want to spoil it, but as soon as I can skip, I'm going to skip. Won't let me skip. I'm out of coffee. Skipping, and there we go. We're now in the third biome. As you can see, all the stuff we have done is now gone. But if you follow the story, you understand why he's gone. And now when we, if we die, we will respawn here in this biome, okay? This biome has a few new enemies, and the turrets are now your worst enemy. The turrets have direct lasers, which just lock on you, and you need it to. I cannot stress this enough. Keep moving this biome. You stop, you die. What is that? Is that ether? No. So you do keep your, as you can see, I kept my ether, right? So I'm going to use that as much as possible to keep my character developing. This is what I did. They usually have opulence. So let's go to the upgrade room, which usually gets smacked up in. So this upgrade room is always fishy to me because enemies, like I said, can spawn whenever you use this. This will increase our integrity. It'll make our life bar longer. But has also the option, the possibility of spawning enemies in this tiny room to your detriment, obviously. So there we go. We were lucky this time. All right, so that was a good little run right there. Let's go ahead and move on. Give me my gun, please. Oh, I'm gonna take it because it's better than most. This is actually quite a OP gun. When used correctly, as you can see, and it leaves this trail of acid which damages all the other enemies on this line in the area. And as you can see, it only has one round, but if used correctly, it's also very effective. Trap, you don't ever want to go in there. There's a little buy station in there kind of thing, but you never have enough money to use it, so I just avoid it. Alright, so these are new enemies. They literally just vomit bullets everywhere. What else is in there? What's another one? Cut it out. Whenever you see that red shield on them, you know what that means. Oh yeah, I see you, revenge new. Even with a gun I don't like. The game is liking me today and providing me with a ton of healing. This unless you have the upgrade from item 6. I'll be honest, I used to get in there and get it anyway. I would get hit because when I first got here, having adrenaline was not as important as just surviving. So yeah, I would take the hit just to make sure I got obelisks to buy stuff. Can't open the chest, that's great. And again, this room is where the pool is. So most out your most out of suffer damage with people about it. No sir. I honestly think that is a dumb thing to pick up. I don't want because you can get a little bit terrible. Never mind. And I left to all my days. Alright, so spend that ether. Oh, wait, that just appeared out of nowhere. That was weird. Give me my gun, man. Come on, man. Oh, I need a gun room, guys. I need a gun room. Oh, is there in a gun room? Leave the losing damage to one target enemies. Hold fire. Personal item. Huge chances of finding salvage from all stuff. Yeah. We have a key, so we can move the back of this room and see what happens. Man! I keep messing myself up. Auto repairs are going to take you separate damage from long falls. Let's go ahead and take off the parasite. We don't have any parasites on right now. That is true. We're in a new stage. Sweet heavens, as always. If I die, we will pick this up tomorrow. From here, from Biome 3. So, if this is your first time in Biome 3, when you come down here, what happens is, so this door is closed when you get in here, and then you have two doors. You got this one, and this one. You gotta go through. When you're done going through them, then you could open that door. So, we could go, but we're not gonna go. We're gonna go through right now. We're trying to get in right now. Drones as. Yeah, the drones in this level don't change either. Drones are savage regardless. That's that. That's the way the drones work. Drones are savage and that's that. Now give me my gun. Let's go finish this game. Not my gun. Again, you won't see this if you haven't finished Biome 6 yet. So that gives me access up here. This is actually where you get the, on your first playthrough when you do this, you get to read this glyph, and you get the Coil Spine Shredder, I believe the name of the gun is, which is a pretty sick gun, to be honest. But it does require a steady hand. Great, the room is about to get locked, is it? No? Okay, we're good then. Good old damage over time, baby. Just take your time and you got it. I'm not sure. I think I'll stick with the rock. The rock plant. Good job so far. Alright, let's get in this upgrade room and see what we can get over there. Hopefully there's no pain. Nope, not messing with that. That's the worst thing in the game. Damage over time, baby. Go ahead and add that. Wasn't this an upgrade door I went into? What in the world? Stressed out in this level right now. You got a shield around. Why wouldn't you have a shield around? Force, yes. Yeah. Best thing to do, give you a shield. Let me see what 5e for me. We'll risk it for the biscuit. Give me my gun, yeah? Nah, that seems to be a little to reduce all effect of my true substances. Bless. Let's do that. Nah, I should have hit him first because he was targeting. That's my bad. I blew that. Yeah. as 3, oh my, this is definitely OP. I like this gun, man. Alright, this gun's pretty cool all of a sudden. I wasn't a fan, but it's kind of making me feel like, you know what? You could use it, guy. Chest up here somewhere. Nah, but I'm gonna take my gun instead though. Yeah, we're gonna hold this gun right here though. Yeah, we got about 6 rounds in it. Yes sir. That's nice. But it doesn't have, you want a portal. So this gun is so crazy it has a portal that will come out and actually shoot at enemies for you. That's the whole secret, really good stuff. Alright, let's see. This is definitely risking it for the biscuit type of material. Wow, that thing hit me in the air with it. Wow, that's nuts, bro. Not dying, what's going on here, bro? Oh, come on. Stupid beams, bro. Plus 5% per jump. I wanted to reach or let you. But that's fine. Coilless punch. There's this one. Jump out of this one. That's alright. Spoiler isn't helpful, we're not doing that. Here's what I like about this room. There's a bunch of her, like, just data. I think this is the room. They have it, like, posed up in different corners. This guy is probably the other one. But she posed up all over the room. Like, just dead. It's crazy. Anyway, time to go back. So in this room, you'd have gotten the key. And then you'd have made it. You'd have had to come all the way back to the boss room, which is here, and go into this other door. And get the other key to go fight the boss. Now, for some weird reason, the game doesn't always let me go fight the boss in this level, so we might have to skip this boss fight. Because, like I said, some weird reason, it doesn't always let me fight it. It just doesn't put up the portal to let you go up. So I'm actually going to use my health. Just to make sure I have it going in ready. Never do that one. Never do the one where you get damage from picking up items. That is the most terrible thing. No way. What, they put me in a room with four of these dudes? Easy. Easy. I got the protection stuff, so I can come down here. You can't do that unless you got the protection thingy. I get it. We got a key. I don't think I've ever opened this door. I see what I'm going to do. Fixing malfunction repairs and tendency. Oh yeah. Now, because I have the upgrade, I could jump in the water here. When we finally get the upgrade, I'll let you know there's going to be a glyph down here to scan, so remember to come back here if you want to do that, like, 100% thing that some people are so obsessed with. There's also a chest up here. Always malignant, always malignant. There's gonna be a weird in here. Combinations are just terrible. This is one of those terrible combinations of shoes. You can't win for losing, like they say. So yeah, we got smacked a bit, so we need to. So, and if you want a casual playthrough again, this would be where you get the other key to go open the boss door. So we're gonna go ahead and efficiency augment now. We're not gonna do something like that. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and jump in here. Teleport back to the boss room, act like we just got the last key. Boom, right there. So we're going for 2 hours and we're about to end by 3. Okay, so let me see if I could go by. Did I buy the health upgrade here? Did I? Would it appear that I have? So we already have that upgrade. So we're gonna go fight the boss as efficient as we are. Let's see if it'll let us even fight the boss at all. So, typically there would be a teleport beam here that takes you up to fight the boss. I would have loved to fight this boss for you guys, but for some reason, sometimes it never shows up. And that reason is I do not know. Okay, so you fight him, he basically gives you a key. With that key, you come back down and you go over here to the left. And that would take us to the frozen tundra. I just got stuck on one of my bottles and I don't remember. She's just all over the place, dead in all types of ways. It's more than weird to watch. Unless if I'm missing something and there's a way to go up to fight the boss. I have checked and tried and I haven't found any lately. Sometimes it shows up, I don't know what I need to do to trigger it. Oh wait, wait, this is it, this is it. I can go up here. There we go, there we go. So, I don't have a key, so I can't open that anyway. So we're gonna go fight the boss. We might not make it because I usually get hit quite a bit by him. I get distracted by him for some reason. So I might get smacked up, but that's fine. That's why we're here. So I get smacked up progressively around that. So, and I was missing the cliff right here as well. Man. Because I've been trying to get back up here and it hasn't been letting me, so I'm happy to do this time. We're about to go disturb this man. This man over there plays his piano. Not disturbing nobody. We're about to go mess him up. We're about to go mess up his dick. There's nothing over here, really. Nothing over here. Really, there's nothing over here.
this melody from me? Or did I learn it from you?
If I make it, it's gonna be a clearer state miracle, I'll tell you that. Alright peeps, that's it for me for tonight. We'll take it from Biome 3 tomorrow. We'll come out here, we'll smack him, we'll get it right. Next time we stream, we're going to smack him up. Again, thank y'all for watching. There are a bunch of people in here tonight, so I want to thank y'all, like a total of 5 people, which is a lot for me actually, believe it or not. So we're going to go ahead and try to raid somebody real quick. Let's see what we got online we can raid. Alright everyone, thank y'all for stopping by, I appreciate it, this was fun. We're gonna finish it up. Typically I just play right through and just beat everything and just go right through, pause and beat everything, but we're gonna finish it up tomorrow.